Senator Rizzo and Devera seeking a Senate probe into government's sugar imports. Last month, the Agriculture Department ordered the importation of 440,000 metric tons of sugar to curb the rising price of the basic commodity. But Ontivero says the importation order may just result in a windfall for the DA's three handpicked importers.
It is a cartel that generates super profits, none of which will go to the National Treasury. Hindi pa tayo kahit kailan nakaranas ng ganitong kagarapal na monopolyo. Walang ganito kahit noong panahon pa ng martial law dictatorship. Every day that we let this pass unhindered is a day of burden for our consumers, suffering the highest prices of basic commodities we have seen in decades. Every day that we let this pass, I dare say, is a blemish on the record of the Senate.
A statement of confidence and not a statement of disgust. That's how PDP Laban Secretary General Melvin Matibag described the remark of Senator Padilla, who earlier said he would leave the party if they won't support charter change. He also clarifies there is no rift within the party.
Wala naman pong problema sa PDP Laban at katunayan, inihayag naman po namin yung suporta sa itinutulak niya constitutional amendments. Ang pagkakaiba lamang po ngayon ang pinag-uusapan ay yung modality po. Alam na po niya na suportado ng partido yung kanyang ginagawa. Kaya nagsalita na siya to make it known to the public na there is really a need to change the constitution. So siguro po yung timing is proper, tama po ngayon. Tsaka po yung direction at tsaka po yung mga kumikilos na tao. It will be a convergence of all of those things na tingin ko po makapagsulong talaga na magkaroon po ng iniitay natin na charter change.
That sunken tanker that caused a massive oil spill in Oriental Mindoro has finally been found. Our very own Dennis Dato now joins us with more details. Dennis, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. 3 weeks after the sink of the empty press that caused an oil spill in Oriental Mindoro and neighboring provinces, the oil tanker was finally found under the sea using a remotely operated vehicle or ROV that arrived yesterday from Japan. The good news was announced by Governor Romelito Dulor this afternoon and is expected to give a media briefing later. Meanwhile, Justice Secretary Boying Rimulya arrived here in Pola, Oriental Mindoro, and where he declared all the areas affected by the oil spill as a crime scene after he personally saw what happened to Pola, which was severely affected. According to Secretary Rimulya, they continue to prepare criminal, civil, and administrative cases that may be filed against the owner of the ship, RDC Real Marine Services. Secretary Rimulya also said that the Coast Guard and Marina people are not safe from the case because of possible negligence in their sides after the empty Princess Empress sailed even without certificate of public convenience. The Justice Department also encouraged those affected to file a writ of kalikasan to compel the owner to help them, especially those who lost their livelihoods. According to Secretary Mulya, they went to the town of Pola at the request of Mayor Jennifer Cruz to help them file the case. Secretary Mulya also encouraged other affected towns and Oriental Governor Romelito Dulor himself to file a case. Secretary Mulya denied that there was a cover-up because they have not released the name of the owner of the industrial fuel that was carried by the MT Princess Empress. Mulya explained they are still completing the information on who is the owner of the oil cargo. Marmina.
Thanks a lot. Dennis Dato there joining us on the line.